Hi, we're still in November 2011, and this is Susan Haynes. I want to talk about dynamic programming approaches to solving problems in the context of the subset sums problem. The subset sum problem is almost the same as the knapsack problem, classic computer science problem. The problem is, given a set of n items, each item has a weight. Here are my weights, W1, W2, up to WN. Choose a subset of those items that will maximize the sum of their weights, but under the constraint that that sum of the weights is less than or equal to an upper bound. Now, let's come up with some weights just to see, just to have a general idea of approaches to solving this problem. So let's just take three items. W1 has weight 2, W2 has weight 2, and W3 has weight 3. And let's suppose my capital W equals 6, okay? So a brute force approach to this would be, okay, generate all 2 to the n subsets, and then calculate the weights and choose the max. So I have 3 items here, so that means I will be generating 8 subsets. So let me go ahead and write down those 8 subsets here. Let's see. So basically I have, let me write down the binary numbers from 0 to 8. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, so from 0 to 7, that gives me 8 possibilities. 0 indicates that that item is not present, and 1 will indicate that that item is present. So the subset I'm referring to right here is the empty set. This subset that I'm referring to right here is W3 only. I'm not going to put the set markers anymore, it'll get cluttered. This subset right here indicates W2 only. Here I have W2 and W3. Here I have W1 only, W1 and W3, W1 and W2 right here, and W1 and W2 and W3 right here. Okay, so the sum of the weights will be 0 for this, for W3 is 3, for W2 is 2, for 2 and 3 together is 5, for W1 only is 2, 1 and 3 together is 5, 1 and 2 together is 4, and the 3 of them together give me 7, which I can't have because it's greater than W, greater than 6. So that's going to be rejected right out of hand because it fails. And then of the rest of these right here, I've got 2 possible choices that are my optimum choices. I can have the set W2 and W3 or the set W1 and W3. I should add that constraint here, max less than or equal to capital W. Okay, so there's my brute force approach to finding the solution to my problem. And we know that brute forces, where I have things that are expanding at this rate, are very computationally expensive.